Hi there, Natalie with you today with a new process video for Scrapbook Nerd. And this time I'm going to show you a quick and easy way to create a layout using the new Maggie Holmes Heritage collection. And this collection is beautiful, very feminine, very beautiful palette. So my idea is I have this picture of my family. These are my kids, my niece and nephew, actually my sisters who are much younger than me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play with some of the papers, and this is going to be based all on pattern paper. I'm not going to use cardstock for my background. I actually want to use some of the paper. And my idea is I really love this stripy paper. I think it's very neutral, so I'm gonna bring color into it by adding two other pattern papers. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create borders. I'm gonna create an edge. I want to create something scallop. I'm gonna bring some movement to the page, and I'm using this punch is called scallop, dotted scallop, and it's from EK Success. And I really love this, the soft I can see the scallop edge, the round edge. So you're gonna see that I'm gonna actually do the edge of these I want to say this peach kind of grid paper. And then I went to look for another paper that brought some more of the colors, and I found this kind of purplish muted with blue and these little roses, and I'm just gonna punch the same edge. So what I'm gonna do now is I make sure that when I punch the edges, they kind of weave together. So if I started with a full scallop on the left hand side of the page, I want to make sure that the second paper only had half the scallop, so that the points where the scallops meet fit at different intervals in the paper. So now that I have that in place, all I'm going to do is I'm going to layer them together so that, like I said, the scallops kind of meet each other. Once I have that in place, I'm going to trim the papers because I don't want to waste the paper, and then I'm going to glue them onto the stripy paper. This all comes from the paper pad. I have the paper pad from the collection. Once I have that in place, I'm gonna make sure you're gonna see that I also used a pen just to kind of help me curl the edges of the scallops and create some of the movement. But once I have that in place, I'm just gonna go ahead and glue it in place. You can add stitching if you want to. Again, I am at the moment packing to go away, so I'm just creating a quick idea for a project, or in this case a layout. So I think that just by gluing it together, it works fine. I would have stitched, but like I said, I'm really short on time, so I wanted to give you an idea on how to create something really fun and easy with just pattern paper and in a short amount of time. So you're gonna see now that I have them, I glued the two pieces together, and what I'm gonna do right now is just gonna start building the layout. Now this collection, and I love acetate. I know some people are not a fan of it, but I really really love acetate. So you're gonna see that I'm gonna bring the acetate paper, which is one of the specialty papers that is included in this collection, to actually help me build the cluster on the picture. So all you're gonna see right now is I'm just dealing with the layout. But once I start working on building this layout, I already am gonna back the picture with a piece of acetate. And I think that I know that I wanted to do that just to bring some shine to the picture. If you see, the background is really muted and the picture is also black and white, so by adding those pop of gold, it's gonna help me kind of make it stand out, one, and also gonna create that soft, the acetate is gonna create just like a softness behind the picture that I cannot add with paper. So once I have that, I'm gonna add a piece of chipboard behind it. I don't wanna add foam, I don't want it to be like really high on the page. So I'm just gonna add a piece of chipboard and I'm gonna glue it in place. Now I find this sticker in the chipboard sticker that says life is lovely, and I thought it was going to be the perfect title. It's the perfect size relative with the picture. It's a 4x6 picture, so I thought the title was big enough to kind of balance it. And then what I find in my stash at home is I have lots of cutouts from cut files that I created for different projects, and I usually cut sometimes extra ones just in case that I need to add it or I need to trim some of them. So I'm going to bring some of these flower cut files, and these are from Handy Papier, and you're gonna see that all I'm gonna do right now is I'm just gonna start putting things where I think they're gonna go. I'm not gluing them yet because I want to play with some of the ideas. So what I've done is I've added my title, added some wax paper behind it. I also brought the sticker that says family. I'm bringing that butterfly ephemera, and what I'm doing right now is I'm building a cluster of embellishments behind the top right corner of the picture, there's a lot of white space there. So you're gonna see that I'm gonna bring some pieces of ephemera. I'm bringing some of the little journaling pockets, and I want to bring some florals, bringing in the color that I have on the second scallop layer, and it has this like really muted corn blue. So I found this sticker in the little sticker tablet, and they're actually clear. So my choice is, instead of gluing it onto cardstock, I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of fussy cut around the area behind the sticker, and then that's gonna give me that white border that I'm looking for. And then I'm just gonna add some foam adhesive behind it. You're gonna see that I'm gonna bring some leaves. I chose not to fussy cut them, and I'm gonna glue them straight onto the paper. You're gonna see that I brought another extra flower just to bulk up the little cluster there. And then I had that little banner made out of vellum, and you're gonna see that it actually, I'm gonna take it out. I thought it was too many words already at that corner, and but instead I'm gonna play with some other ideas. One of the elements that repeats throughout this collection are little I don't know how you call them, they're like ribbons when you win like a prize ribbon. So I'm gonna bring one of those shapes into this layout, and you're gonna see that I'm actually gonna add a little foam, a glue dot behind it, just to give it a little bit of a lift. And then I'm gonna bring some of those puffy stickers. Now another thing that also repeats a lot is gold accents. So I'm gonna bring these little photo corners and just gonna glue them to the picture, just to bring those accents onto the layout. And once I have that in place, you're gonna see that I'm gonna add some puffy stickers that tell things about the story. I think the puffy sticker that I'm adding says together, and I'm just adding another flower just to soften some of the black. After that, now that I'm happy what that looks like, I'm gonna add some foam adhesive behind the chipboard just to keep it in place. And then I'm gonna bring some of the stickers from the cardstock sticker, and that one says I love this. And you're gonna see that I'm gonna add it right underneath the title, in between the two layers of paper, and I thought it was the perfect spot. Slowly you're gonna see that the way my design is created, it's kind of a zigzag from the top right corner of the picture to the title, which is a top, it's kind of a diagonal, and then it zigzags to the butterfly at the bottom, so it gives you that movement on the page. After that, you're gonna see that once I glue the word family, I'm gonna bring some of the clear stickers from the booklet. There's a booklet of stickers in this collection, and I'm just gonna add a few sentiments. I'm gonna add one there, and I'm also gonna add another one on the right at the bottom of the picture. After that, I'm just gonna add some gold ink splatters around the page, and I added my lines of journal right underneath the family sticker, the puffy sticker at the bottom, and that's about it. This layer took 35 minutes to put together from start to finish, and I love how it turned out. I hope you try it. As always, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me. I would love to help you. Thank you so much for coming today to visit, and don't forget to check everything. It's available at the ScrapbookNerd shop. Thank you so much, guys, and I hope to see you very soon. Take care.